This video will review logistics of a bronchiolitis admission. You should become very familiar with bronchiolitis by the end of your hospital medicine rotation. We will review how to place admission orders for patients with bronchiolitis using the standardized order set. We will review using the CRS in assessing a patient with bronchiolitis, as well as key points to give in discharge instructions to parents. The actual management of bronchiolitis will be reviewed with you in other educational formats, such as during lectures and on rounds. You can also always refer to the 2014 AAP guidelines in managing bronchiolitis. The order set for bronchiolitis was updated and implemented in September of 2016 to match the AAP management guidelines and also as part of a nationwide QI project called Stewardship in Improving Bronchiolitis. We are currently participating in a statewide QI project, so the order set may continue to have minor changes. To find the bronchiolitis admission order set, click on Sets on your order page, start typing bronchiolitis in the search box, and then select the PED bronchiolitis order set. The other option is only the protocol orders, not the full admission orders. There are many orders in the set that are needed. You will notice that the new protocol is based on the clinical respiratory score. When you are examining a patient with bronchiolitis, you will use the CRS as you do for patients with asthma. You must do this on your admission exam and on your follow-up assessments to give you a more objective idea of how your patient is improving or worsening. This is the CRS card you should have on your badge or in your pocket. Give a score for each category and add up the total. If the patient is on oxygen, turn it off when you start your exam and watch to see what the SpO2 is while on room air. If the patient is hypoxic or less than 90%, turn the oxygen back on once you have assessed this category. Remember to always inform the nurses if you change the oxygen level. This is the new bronchiolitis protocol as a flow diagram. Copies can be found on the floors as well as the 7th floor workroom. Notice that the use of nasopharyngeal or deep suctioning is now crossed out. We are now discouraging the use of deep suctioning due to a study that showed that consistent external nasal suctioning of at least every 4 hours, as well as avoiding nasopharyngeal deep suctioning, helped reduce the length of stay for bronchiolitis. Patients who received deep suctioning or went more than 4 hours without getting nasal suctioning had longer lengths of stay. Using deep suctioning for very severe patients, such as with a CRS of greater than 8, may be considered in an attempt to stabilize them, but it should not be used frequently or with every suction for those patients. The first several default selections are basic admission orders. Be sure to edit the admission status even if there is an order in from the ED. The smoking cessation order is there for the nurses to ask, but it is also your responsibility to ask if anyone who cared for the child smokes and to ensure that it is documented in your H&P. If there is smoke exposure, counsel about smoking cessation and advise them to discuss nicotine replacement therapy with their own PCP. Be sure to document that you did this. You have to select which oxygen therapy the patient needs. If none, don't select any. RC oxygen therapy is for nasal cannula, while the next order is for starting high-flow nasal cannula. If you open the order, it will provide guidelines for when to start high-flow nasal cannula, at what rate, and FiO2, which we will review in a moment. Be sure to also select the oxygen weaning protocol order if you select an oxygen order. These are the high flow nasal cannula guidelines for starting high flow in the new protocol. Remember that these are guidelines and they are not set in stone. This is the flow diagram of the oxygen weaning protocol. You should have an understanding of this so that you can help guide the nurses and respiratory therapists. Moving down the order set, you'll notice that the diet orders are separated by what CRS the patient has. Select the appropriate one. The preference is to use enteral feeds, either oral or by NG, over IV fluids. However, if you need IV fluids, you can expand the IV fluid module. Notice that you may want to avoid oral feeds for more severe patients, but you can still use NG feeds. If the CRS is greater than 8, they should be NPO until stabilized. You should not need to order any labs or imaging for patients with bronchiolitis. The AAP guidelines recommends against labs and imaging. Notice that the bronchiolitis protocol is automatically checked. You don't need to do anything else for this. If you click Edit, you will see the protocol written out per CRS. Please review the protocol flow diagram to understand what the nurses and RTs will be doing. Edits to this will be coming. For instance, we will be removing the instruction to use nasotracheal suctioning, as there is evidence that using this deep suctioning can prolong length of stay. Nurses and RTs should only perform nasal suctioning. If you click the blue eye, you can see the inclusion and exclusion criteria for being on the protocol and a CRS chart if you don't have your card. There are inclusion and exclusion criteria for being on the protocol. Basically, the protocol should be used for your straightforward patients with bronchiolitis. The last part of the order set has options to order Tylenol and Motrin if needed. The order to nurses and RTs for suctioning is embedded within the protocol order. However, for clarity, you can add this as a separate order and edit it to say per protocol. To find it, search for RCNUR and select the RCN Nursing Perform Suction order. When discharging a patient with bronchiolitis, there are things that the parents need to know and to continue to do for the patient at home. Let the parents know that the cough and congestion could last another 1 to 2 weeks. The cough will linger and be the last thing to resolve. However, they should expect to see gradual improvement each day. The parents must continue to suction the nose. To do this, they put a few drops of saline in the nostril, close the other, and use a bulb syringe or other suction device to suction that nair. Then repeat on the other side. Suctioning should happen several times a day as needed, especially before eating and sleeping. Babies with bronchiolitis often have a hard time eating due to nasal congestion. Instruct the parent to feed less amount more often if the baby is struggling or not eating as much. When writing your discharge summary, please include the following statement if it is true. This is a quality initiative that we are following.